Good morning, everyone. This is Isoroku Yamamoto, and this morning I would like to present the German Spitfire VDB605 again, with its various builds, and I'm going to highlight the best builds in my opinion, and specifically the single best build, which is not the build that I'm currently using. And I'd like to highlight differences between these builds. So first of all, I already discussed, in my opinion, there's only one possibility for the cockpit slot. You definitely have to pick up a side here, no other possibility. Other than that, I don't like survivability builds, so we are going with maneuverability or speed builds. Or, of course, a crossover build. So basically what I've done is list a couple of possibilities, being a full maneuverability build where we take two maneuverability possibilities, one for the airframe, one for the engine, and the first one being something that doesn't downgrade our maneuverability, which would be the reinforced skin. This is what I currently have on my own Spitfire. The disadvantage of this build is that it reduces your aircraft speed. Now, the maneuverability, when you completely spec for this, would look like this, but then with this fully upgraded, is that you get a survivability of 6, a maneuverability of up to 111, which is insanely high, and a speed of down to 40, up to 42, depending on what. Exactly what quality you use. If it goes down to 40, then the cruise speed results at 384 km per hour, which is pretty slow. So the other end of the spectrum is of course a speed build, where we use a polished skin over here, the uprated engine over here, and something that doesn't decrease our velocity over here, which might as well be the lightweight wing frame, which increases maneuverability, and effectively that will be a crossover build with speed and maneuverability, so I'm gonna treat those as one already. Now we can see here that the cruise speed of this is quite high, being 565 kilometers per hour, and yeah, that's quite insane, and it's close to the boost speed in fact. The downside of this build is that your maneuverability is it's good, it really is good, it's significantly better than where it starts out at, and it already starts out at 86 or 83, something like. But it's not insanely good. I mean, in the maneuverability build we end up at 111 and this one ends up at 95, so that's a complete 16 points lower, is it? Yeah, so that's pretty severe. There is however one other option, and that is to make a crossover build using both the speed and maneuverability slots in the airframe, but simply using the maneuverability slot for the engine, and this gives a really interesting result. So if we look now what happens here, the airspeed goes down a bit to 503, which is it's a notch slower than in the true speed build, but the maneuverability goes up to 107, which is 12 points higher, whereas this decreased by 5 points. We can also see that the survivability is at 5% now. Yeah, survivability isn't my thing that much anyway. But this build is way quicker than the true maneuverability build. Sure, we've lost 4 points of maneuverability here, 107 versus 111 in a true maneuverability build, but we've also gained 10 points in terms of airspeed. So let's see how it performs, and this will be the only build that I'll go over. Note that I don't have a truly specialized pilot, but it's got the basics. It's got aerodynamics expert and acrobatics expert. So yeah, this will be actual battle footage of the Spitfire VDB in maneuverability slash speed build, and I already have one. It's anti-darting at me, which is cozy. You can see that it is pretty fast, of course. It's also pretty maneuverable, which is what we're building for. But unlike my maneuverability build, I can now close in on these targets just by speed. And that's nice. When we compare this build to base rather than to a maneuverability build or speed build, we see that the maneuverability has gone up from 83 to 107, significant increase, and the speed has increased from 40 to 50, so also again a significant increase. Yeah, this aircraft is in its base configuration without any upgrades. It's a very enjoyable play. And many people will find that they can, work their way around them. They'll enjoy it. It's a really good fight. But once you start upgrading this thing, it becomes absolutely beastly. And this configuration, so the polished skin, the lightwing airframe, and the lightwing engine, it's just a straight out amazing combination. And of course, if you have some spare time, credits, and materials, which I have, of course, especially on my CC account, but I can also do that on my own account. Then make sure to reassemble your equipment such that you get all the bonus effects that you'd want. So heavy inbound here, let's see, it's a bot, but still gonna see if I can get it up. Right now my wings have actually gotten shelled out, and that's something that would happen less often with my previous build, in theory, except that my previous build had less speed. Having less speed means you may end up in certain situations more often, which in fact still means that you might end up getting shelled out more often. This is not looking good. Didn't go well. But all in all, this is a very, very enjoyable build. So if I were to choose now for a build, I would definitely go with the double maneuverability single speed build. You can only do that in the Spitfire through the combination that I gave,
being polished
skin,
enemy bombers
lightwing airframe, and
destroy them.
The lightwing engine. And of course there are other possibilities, but this one is really, really enjoyable. And if you now have an aircraft such as the Yak-19, Yak-30, in general high tier fighters, I guess, which actually has two engine slots, might also include the upgraded engine. Why not? It will go even a bit faster. Yeah, yeah, guys, breathe against one, we get it. My wing is damaged, so I can't do shit here. Well, that nearly was fun. Sorry about that, that was a bit frustrating. So if we look at the battle here right now, things are looking pretty bright. We have two mining farms and two garrisons versus the only command center of the enemy, and the command center is being heavily attacked. And whereas when I was over there, I was the only one attacking. I can go over there pretty quickly again. And yeah, we have already got a huge points lead, so we are definitely winning this one. Quite possibly, if... No. I was gonna say if the mining plant hurries a bit, we might even win before school, but that's not happening. This is definitely not one of my best battles, not even one of my better battles, I'd say, but... that doesn't make this aircraft in this configuration any less enjoyable. Obviously, the fun thing with this aircraft is that basically anything that I told you pretty much translates straight towards the British Spitfire T6. Not sure of its exact name, it's the DBIM or something alike. Simply because, hey, that was my wing. That aircraft behaves a bit differently, but not that much. Establishing communication with the main. So if you like what you're seeing here, but you don't have the Spitfire, the German Spitfire, you do have that one, you might as well try it out on that one. And it will work pretty much in the same way. So I hope you guys enjoyed. Rick, thank you for requesting this video. I hope showing this build is sufficient for now. Might do videos on the other builds as well, see what their advantages and drawbacks are. And for now, I wish you all a very good day. See you all around.